Hello children, I am Sunandini Chegam, SA Bioscience in GHS Burkampat. In earlier classes, we have seen excretion in human beings and we shall study in this class about the excretory organs in other animals and plants. All living organisms are divided into different groups based upon their characteristics, and different organisms use different strategies in excretion. Animals are divided into invertebrates and vertebrates. Among invertebrates, excretory organs are absent in unicellular organisms, example amoeba and paramecium. You see, in the picture of amoeba, the big contractile vacuole, it plays an important role in excretion. Now, freshwater organisms like amoeba, paramecium possess osmoregulatory organelles called as contractile vacuole. You can see here, it collects water and waste from the body, swells up, reaches the surface and breasts to release its content to outside. The main excretion takes place through body surface called diffusion.
See, multicellular organisms possesses different excretory organs for removal of wastes from the body. Excretory structures appear for the first time in flatworms, that is in platyhelminthes, and they are known as flame cells. You can see the picture of flame cells here, the blue colored cilia, they will be moving always because of this floating movement of the cilia. They are named as the flame cells. In your textbook, the tabular form for different organisms of the phyla are given, and the excretory organs are also given in protozoa, as said earlier in amoeba. A simple diffusion process takes place in Podiferan ciliterata. Water bathes almost all these cells. In platyhelminthes, flame cells occur. In nematoda, rennet cells. In annelids, nephridia or the excretory organs. In arthropods, green glands, malpighian tubules or the excretory organs. In mollusks, metanephridia or the excretory organs. In echinodermata, a water vascular system is present, that is in starfishes. In the chordates, which have vertebral column like aves, reptiles and mammalia, kidneys are the excretory organs. And have you ever had doubt that how plants excrete? Do plants excrete like animals? Yes, they also excrete. Let us see the excretion and release of substances in plants. Plants produce carbon dioxide and water vapor as the respiratory waste products. Oxygen itself is considered as a waste product in photosynthesis. They expel out these gases through stomata of the leaves and lenticels of the stems. You see in this picture, carbon dioxide, oxygen emerging out through the stomata of the leaf, and here water is exuding out through the stamens. Here, plants do not have specific excretory organs. They store their excretory products in the roots, bark, stem, and also in the leaves and fruits. When they ripen, they fall off and the excretory products, wastes, are removed from the plant body. And especially in case of fruits, they are stored in the form of solid bodies called as the rhaphides. And they also synthesize certain chemicals. They convert these waste products into waste chemicals, which are stored in roots, bark, leaves, and also seeds, which are very hard to be eaten by the herbivorous animals. They have very unpleasant smell and taste, so that the herbivores cannot eat them, or if they eat also, they will die immediately. Example, the poison nut. If the goats eat them, they die. And also some Apocynaceae members like Nerium, in Telugu it is called Ganneru. Goats won't eat them because of the presence of the toxins in the leaves. This is a sort of protection accompanied by the plants. Some plants secrete chemicals around their roots to attract the bacteria like rhizobia. These rhizobia form root nodules and they help in the nitrogen metabolism in plants. And these compounds are known as the secondary metabolites. Biochemicals produced by plants are of two types. One are primary metabolites and secondary metabolites. Primary metabolites include the carbohydrates, proteins, fats and vitamins which are used by the plants for their growth. And these secondary metabolites are the chemicals which are not used by the plants for their growth and development. Instead, these secondary metabolites are used for the protection and other purposes which we shall discuss. And these are alkaloids, tannins, resins, gums and latex. Alkaloids, and these are the nitrogenous products and are poisonous, stored in different parts of the plant. You can see the papaver somniferum, Rhizobia serpentiana pictures given in your textbook, Caffea arabica, tobacco plant, and this is Pogaku in Telugu, and Datura umetta in Telugu, a name that you know Vepachettu. And here is a tablet form of the alkaloids, the name of the plant from which they are obtained, parts from which they are attained, and also their uses. See here, quinine, cinquina, officinalis plants, bark it is obtained. It is used as anti-malarial drug. Nicotine is obtained from Nicotiana tabacum, the tobacco, and from its leaves. Insecticide and stimulant is prepared. Morphine and cocaine is obtained from papaver somniferum. It is opium, in Telugu it is nallamandu, and its fruit is used as a pain killer. And reserpine is obtained from Rhizobia serpentina, and as the name indicates, serpentina, it is used as a medicine for snake bite. It is called snake root, it's a common name, and root part is used for medicine for snake bite as well as high BP. Caffeine is obtained from Caffea arabica coffee plant. Its seeds are used and used as a stimulant during central nervous system, and that is mainly during operations. And nimbin is obtained from Azadirachta indica, neem plant, and seeds, bark, leaves are also, every plant part is used in neem and as an antiseptic. Scopolamine, it is a drug obtained from, alkaloid obtained from Datura stramonium from its fruits and flower, and it is a sedative. Pyrethroids are obtained from plant chrysanthemum, and its flower is used as insecticide. So students, all these are locally available plants, alkaloids, which are used in one or other way. You should always protect them and just don't pick them and throw them away. Now we shall see, this is Cassia in Telugu, it is Tangedu, very popular plant. And from this, and also Acacia tumma. Tannins are obtained. These are carbon compounds stored in different parts of the plant and a deep browning color, and they are used for tanning of leather and medicines. And here is Pinus plant. I think you might have seen in a Skindasani sanctuary these plants are there. They are gymnosperm plants. If the stem of this plant is cut, you can see some liquids oozing out. These are called as resins, and these resins are used for preparation of varnishes. These are also nitrogenous alkaloids produced by the plants. You can see here the gum, when the stems of Azadirachta, that is neem plant, is bark is removed or wounded, some gum comes out, liquid part comes out, it absorbs water, swells, and it covers the wounds. And these are also used for adhesives and binding agents in book binding, in preparation of medicines and also foods. Do you know they are used in ice creams? No. Yes, they are used in ice creams and also modern foods. Here is example of the jatropha, and here you see the rubber plant, and from this some white color liquid is extracted. A latex is sticky milky substance secreted by plants, and it is stored in the latex vessels of the plant. And latex of Hevea brasiliensis is used in preparation of rubber, and that of jatropha is used as a source for biodiesel. Latex of chicle and sapota are used in preparation of chewing gum nowadays. And here roots also secrete some specific substances or chemicals into the soil. And in apple crop, if the same crop is grown for 5 years in same area, in the next year the yield is very low. This is because some of the secretions of the roots spoil the fertility of the soil. So these alkaloids are useful for the plant in some way, and also useful for the man in another way. And what is the difference between secretion and excretion? What is the difference between secretion and excretion? Here, excretion is removal of waste materials in the living beings, and secretion is movement of materials from one point to the another. Excretion is passive, secretion is active. Humans excrete materials such as tears, urine, carbon dioxide and sweat, as we said earlier. And they secrete, on the other hand, enzymes, hormones and saliva. These are the secretions of human beings. And in plants too, we find excretion through roots in surroundings, and falling of leaves and bark, fruits, etc. is the excretion in plants. And in plants, secretion of latex, resins and gums takes place. Now, from this chapter, we get questions like, what are the excretory organs in unicellular organisms? What are rhaphides? What are secondary metabolites? And write about the different parts of alkaloids, where they are produced, and also give examples of some drugs prepared from alkaloids. You may also get questions from the tabular form to analyze it. Oh, and also the final question may be, what is the difference between excretion and secretion? So with this, students, we complete the chapter excretion and get prepared for your examinations further. Thank you.